In this video, we're going to be turning this PC right here, decent PC, Lenovo ThinkStation P330 workstation. We're going to be turning it into a superhero PC. See, having a decent PC like this, you know, decent build, decent design, already qualifies the PC as a superhero PC. But then, even though it's already a superhero PC, you still need a superhero SSD to actually make this PC, you know, do exactly what it's supposed to do, which is to deliver you speed, deliver you quality, excellent multitasking abilities, you know, PC that will not give you any stress. Yes, in this video, like I said, we are going to open this PC up and we start thinking we are going to make it a superhero PC. See, gone are the days where it used to be trendy to have a PC with just 4 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM. Gone are those days. Those days are gone. If what you did in 2020 was working for you, understand that we are in 2025. Things have not changed. And if you are not seeing changes to what's already working, you are doing yourself a great disservice. See, guys, the days of 4 gigabytes, they are gone. It's not going to happen again that you will buy a PC online and the PC only has 4 gigabytes. The PC is going to disappoint you at some point because 4 gigabytes is not just enough for you to roll with the big boys these days. Things are pretty much changed. We are in the days of AI. And if you are still running a PC with 4 gigabytes, you are doing something very wrong. This is the reason why this PC here, even though it's already a superhero PC, I still felt like it's absolutely wrong for a PC like this to be rocking 4 gigabytes, you know, of DDR4 RAM. So I'm going to be going ahead, you know, to make this PC get exactly what it has been asking for so long. This PC has been asking for a minimum of 16 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM to enable it to work perfectly the way it was actually intended. And today I said to myself, this day is not going to be ended if I would not give this PC what it wants, which is a 16 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM, as well as a 512 gigabytes of a superhero NVMe SSD. This is about what we are doing right now. If you still have a PC like this, it's not just enough for you to have a ThinkStation. The ThinkStation must be found to have everything that a ThinkStation actually wants. See, gone are the days where a ThinkStation will be allowed to run on very poorly developed, you know, RAM sticks. Gone are the days where a ThinkStation should be run, you know, on poorly developed SSDs. If you have a ThinkStation, please, please, and please ensure that you're using quality parts to upgrade them so that your ThinkStation would not suddenly break up on you. And if you have quality parts like this, there is just no way you're going to wake up in the morning, try to switch on your PC, and then the PC tells you, today, I am not ready to do anything because my RAM sticks are broken. You do not want that to happen to you. So this is the reason why I have carefully chosen the RAM sticks for this PC. And above that, I have carefully chosen the SSD for this PC. See, installing this is pretty much, you know, a one-way process because this PC has gotten everything ready for you. You do not have to begin to fight with a screw or a screwdriver. All you have to do, lift this rubber right here. It's kind of very tight to get into it, but definitely I have to bring it out because I want this SSD right here to be out. So I'm just going to be careful in lifting it so that I do not break anything, because in the event of me breaking something, then it's going to be game over. So I'll flip it over and try again to kind of get my hands on the SSD holder. Just like that. Like I said, it's a little bit tricky here. If you have, you know, a ThinkStation like this and you want to upgrade the SSD, only be careful that you are not seen breaking anything. I have it out, and the next thing I have to do is to carefully lift up, you know, the old SSD that is here. But if you look at the side of this thing, there is a cooler on the SSD. I just have to unclip the cooler on the SSD. In this way, I'm able to actually lift it up. All right. So if you have stuff like this, just be careful. And this is what I mean, guys. This is how you know a superhero PC. It has a cooler on the SSD. So you have absolutely no business, you know, dealing with overheating or stuff like that. I'm just going to keep this here and I'm going to take out the SSD that was there before. Right here is a 256 gigabyte SSD. I really want to think that if you have a decent workstation like this, even though this SSD is a very decent quality SSD, but at some point you're going to be needing something bigger. And this is exactly why I have decided to go with a 512 gigabytes of SSD. Of course, this is not the highest you can go. You can decide to do 1 terabyte. You can decide to do 2 terabytes of SSD. And the list goes on and on and on. Like I said, a superhero PC would not give you any kind of bottleneck. This is one thing that you first want to confirm before you put your hard-earned money on a PC. Gone are the days where you have to spend 400 euros, $500, $1,000 buying a PC. And at the end of the day, you can't seem to do anything with the PC. You want to upgrade the RAM, it's not possible. You want to upgrade the hard drive, it's not possible. You want to put in additional hard drive, it's also not possible. And then at some point, you are forced to ask yourself, why did I actually buy this PC in the first place? Yes, it is just what it is because you were put in a one-chance situation. You didn't ask questions and you ended up buying a one-chance PC. Or better still, you ended up buying a PC that cannot be in any way referred to as a super, you know, hero PC. So if you've got money to spend, ensure that you go for the best. Ensure that you go, you know, with the superhero PCs. There are a lot of them out there. And if you are not so sure what a superhero PC is, ensure to go to the link in the description below. Click on it and you'll be taken to the Hardware Money Shop where you're going to find quite a wide range of superhero PCs that you have absolutely no reason to go out there to buy a PC that cannot do anything for you in 2025. I hope this video helps you. If you still have questions regarding upgrading your ThinkStation PC, make sure to leave me a comment in the comment section. Definitely, I'm going to get back to you. Until I see you again in the next one, peace.